ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान गण प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम्स टू ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड एटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड योर एंटायर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद्गीता वर्स नंबर 12 ऑफ 6th चैप्टर। श्री भगवान उवाच तत्रैकाग्रं मनः कृत्वा यतचित्तेन्द्रियक्रियः उपवेश्यासने युञ्ज्यात् योगमात्मविशुद्धये समं कायशिरोग्रीवं धारयन्नचलं स्थिरः सम्प्रेक्ष्य नासिकाग्रं स्वं दिशश्चानवलोकयन्। भगवान कृष्ण हैज कंप्लीटेड बहिरंग साधनास फॉर मेडिटेशन and there are 8 kinds of things to be observed during the meditation. That's what is being explained by Lord Krishna. In the last class we saw there are 4 things. First we call it deshaha, kalaha, asanam, sharirasthiti. That sharirasthiti means what? Sharirasthiti means giving a proper posture for the meditation. Now this posture needs to be explained a lot because you imagine that when we were in the womb, we were in a different position and we came out with a different position. After that, the whatever the way that we can make the postures, we are just doing for that. We don't teach children how to sit, how to walk, how to sleep, even how to stand. So human being must be taught how to stand first. We call it Tadasana. Tadasana means you stand like a vriksha tree. So you have to place your legs first properly on the earth. And the arch of the leg should be maintained properly. Learn Tadasana. You should know how to land on the earth first. We need to learn how to stand, how to sit. When we sit nowadays, there are furnitures, they collapse our health. We are not aware about it. The people should become aware and children must be taught to use the proper furnitures. All these sofas, some kind of bundle look alike, you know, chairs are, I'm telling, they look like bundles. When you go to a home, they welcome with those bundle. It is kept as though something tied with the bundle. They ask to sit as in that bundle. So it's an unhealthy product. It's not going to help for our health. We have to teach the people how to sit. Use and engage backrest, because when you use the backrest, you lose the potential capacity of your back. The spine will lose its potential. So this teaching has to be given thoroughly to our youngsters. How to sit? When you sit, you have to sit properly, straight, not like, you know, with the stiffness. So as much as possible, straight, not bending or pushing the middle part of the back. No, you have to straight from the bottom of your back. Then you have to widen little bit your chest. You know, chest blade has to be widened. So we need not to shrink it at any point of time. Even all yogasanas, it may twist, it may bend front and back, or it may stretch. We should not lose this portion. We have to keep wide enough this portion, because lungs needs to have the place and space also. These postures, we have to begin from standing, sitting and lying down. When you lie down, as I told you, don't use cushions. Make a simple cushioned table or sofa or bed. Use it that way. But here it is said, the postures, when you sit in the meditation, so your head and body and your legs has to be like a lotus, Padmasana, Sukhasana. So all these asanas I have prescribed already, but these postures, it has got its own plus point. When you sit in the Padmasana, so blood circulation goes straight away to the brain. At the same time, your body cells also being activated and they are kept alive, because bringing inaction to the body is a dangerous thing, I tell you. We can learn little bit in different way. When we went to the womb, we went as a one single cell, isn't it? From that single cell, one more cell came. From those two cells, four cells have come. Then it has multiplied. That multiplication happened in the large amount. Then we got all the organs from heart, lungs, livers, pancreas, all bones, flesh, nerves, everything are nothing but cells. Those all the cells are endowed with the action. Those action only three kind. They receive the food, they digest, and they push the excreta out. These are all the work of the cell. You can learn one cell and you can equate with the body. The body is nothing but one cell. That one cell symbolizes the whole body, because all the cells, trillions of the cells, are accumulated, organized as a body. Though they are in large number, but all of them, they do have consciousness. All those consciousness correlated as a one consciousness. Now, every cell is connected with our consciousness. Now, the cells must be endowed with activity. If a cell is receiving the food, it needs the energy to digest. For that, it needs to have activity. After food are digested, the excreta, whatever remaining as a waste, must be thrown out. For that also, it needs to have the capacity to push it out. If we are not giving enough action in our body, if you are not working enough, if you are not twisting, stretching, bending, then the cells won't get that much energy for our its actions, activity. Then what? It becomes sick. Therefore, when you sit in the meditation, you are purposely denying the action. It means you are collapsing your system. That's what the fact is. We are just thinking about the physical system. Even mental system, psychological system are also based on the cells alone, because cells are containing the consciousness. But Krishna says you should sit straight. Samam kaya shiro grivam dharayan achalam sthiraha. Achalam sthiraha, without movement, being a standstill, and head and bodies are straight, kept, you know, well straight, erected. Body has to be straight enough, but there should not be stiff. Now, how can we interpret it? How will we understand it? We have to sit without activity. At the same time, we have to keep ourselves alive. What to be done? That's what people say are yogis do pranayama. The pranayama is less effort but more beneficial. Even in order to sit for 1 minute, you have to work at least 5 minutes. These all yogasanas, they will twist and you know they will suck all this excreta from your body. This is like, you know, you are just twisting the cloth, all the water will come away. In the same way, it stretches and twist, bending and everything. So your body kept alive every day by doing yogasana. If you want to sit for the meditation for a long time, please just practice yoga. Otherwise, don't sit for meditation. And don't use in other time also. So sitting for the meditation, then you are using all the backrest, sofas, wrong furnitures. You cannot maintain your health. Sitting for meditation should not collapse our health. Now, therefore, Bhagavan Krishna brings the topic, how should we have to maintain the posture of the body? There are so many asanas you have to learn under any yogacharya. All yoga masters are doing well in our places, in our India. Even in foreign countries, people are doing good yoga, but the purpose of yoga must be taught properly. That is very important. The language and prayers with yoga, and yoga is the glorifying action and boon for human society. We have to respect it. When practice yoga, then you sit for meditation, then you can maintain the posture without any movement. Then he brings the topic about prana samyam. These pranas are the great invention by our shastras. Because when a person is dead, we call it, you know, the prana has gone. Prana symbolizes energy. Prana also indicates vayu and also indicates the force. You know, potential energy, that which sustains, that which also endowed with force, means fastness. And in order to throw something, you should have the prana. In order to run, in order to digest the food, you need to have prana. In order to speak a lot, you need to have prana. Body's energy kept alive because of prana. Therefore, the method which we call it prana samya means you should have the proper respiratory pranayama. The respiratory system is given direct exercise called pranayamaha, rearranging or organizing our breathing method. These breathing techniques must be learnt under an acharya. Therefore, we have to learn under a experienced and the skillful acharya how to maintain our breathing method. It is very dangerous. You have to be very serious and you have to learn carefully these things. In normal life, we don't pay attention how we breathe. You might have observed there are two nostrils. The air sometimes comes through one. The right nostrils is called Surya Kala. The left nostrils is called Chandra Kala. You have to learn it, and this Vasi Yoga, they teach completely what is the different mix when it comes through right and it comes through left. But here we need to have Samyam, equal pranayama through both nostrils. You need to have a proper breath which is long and deep, and proper inhalation and exhalations. Sometimes we also should have the Kumbhaka pranayama, not during the meditation, because when you sit for the meditation, you just forget about your body mind. You are keeping yourself very much conscious enough with your thoughts, your goal, therefore you just will forget about your body. Sometimes body will become stand and still, that stability which is needed, but the pranayama. So with your lungs, if we are practicing regularly, they will keep the body alive, because pranas are connected with the cells directly. Therefore, you have to learn pranayama in order to sit for the meditation. We can just, if you don't have the guru, just, you know, you pull your breath as much as possible and just exhale. We call it Nadi Shuddhi. Pull from one nostril and just relieve means just exhale through other nostrils. Inhale through that, again leave it from other nostrils. This is inhalation, exhalation, exhalation, inhalation. So inhale for 15 seconds or as much as you could or you are able to. Then you just leave at the same time, then pull, then leave it. This inhale and exhale, exhale, inhale. From this cycling has to be done at least 15 times once you sit for pranayama. So these techniques and this practice will work. You will get a healthy body, healthy lungs will keep body healthy. Therefore, this pranayama must be learned, because meditation needs pranasamyam, equal inhalation, exhalations, and that too with both nostrils. Okay, then the next is called Indriya Nigraham. And this pranayama, I tell you, don't pull fast and leave it. Learn very slowly. There are so many acharyas. And learn at least the simple techniques how to maintain with pranayama. What I feel, you know, everybody should learn pranayama. And also, when you learn pranayama, you can observe your body, how it is changed. Start pranayama. After, you know, beginning the pranayama, 6 months, you can see a great changes in your physical and psychological level. The pranayama is the big topic. There are so many varieties of pranayama. We are going to have the simple pranayama in order to sit for the meditation. And also is, when you sit, you have to look at on your tip of the nose. Like Lord Shiva, when he sits, you know, the eyes are not closed, our eyes are not even open. It is like as though closed above the way, and the paying attention on the tip of the nose. Because you keep your eyes on the nose means what? So you should not make your eyeballs so focused on the nose. No need. Just keep closed. Your attention must be on the tip of the nose. On the tip of the nose means that is the place is given, because the eyes, when it rolls around, it is, you know, the mind is pulled away. Because it attracts outside of object, then your mind will wander like anything. Therefore, in order to avoid it, you just focus on the tip of the nose. This is anavalokayan, not seeing any direction. Keep yourself with yourself. Then he comes, tatra ekagram manakritva, because Krishna has given in different order. Because 13 words talks about sitting posture, the 12th verse talks about Indriya Nigraha and Mano Nigraha. Tatra ekagram manakritva, there you have to sit with completely focused mind. It is what? So bringing or withdrawing all the indriyas and keeping attention in one place. One place means where you contemplate. And there are places also, we call it a Shadadharas, Shad Chakras, Ajna Chakra, or Nahridaya, there is a chakra. So many chakras, we call it a Shad Chakras, from Manipuraka to Sahasrara. That is a separate teaching. But here the subject matter is Aham. Aham means the I, which is taught in the last chapters. We are going to contemplate on I. We are going to just identify ourselves with the real I. Therefore, you need not worry about physical focus. You can keep your concentration. Physical eyes can keep in front of you, not looking here and there. The mind has to be focused. The indriyas should not be engaged. For that, not only while sitting in the meditation, you should give the practice while eating, while drinking, while listening, while seeing something. You should not allow your indriyas to drive away, or in order to go scattered with the worldly object. Just be careful. Always be careful. For that, you need not to act as a slow motion person. You need not to. Just be normal, but be awareful and conscious enough on your indriyas. They should not let yourself to expose outside. Be careful. When you sit for the meditation, those indriyas should shut themselves in order to keep your mind focused in the topic. Then mano nigraha. So all the attention has been drawn, called dharana. Mano nigraha means sticking with one subject matter, not even jumping to another kind of subject matter, sticking with one subject matter. It's a big deal. It's a very subtle. These are all 8 things. One more thing is there, buddhi nischayaha. This buddhi nischayaha is nothing but the clarity about the destination, clarity about the subject. Not only that, the clarity about the usage of meditation. What is the role of the meditation in the spiritual life? That we have to be aware. So destination is your choice. So normal health and normal peace of the mind and the spiritual growth for anima, mahima, the ashtama siddhis, whatever the goal you may fix, but you focus with that. But the mind has to be trained well for Brahma Jnana. That is what our purpose is. Buddhi nischayaha. I am doing meditation for moksha. That has to be with Vedantic student. Otherwise, normally we can also follow meditation in order to get more talent, more capacity with our body, physical and psychological system, with all our indriyas. You can develop more power in the body. Doesn't matter. It's not wrong at all. But the meditation is meant for moksham. We should not forget it. That's what from Bhagavan Krishna. Bhagavan Krishna is core to the topic, and he hits directly, because being as an almighty, he has to be endowed with clear teaching. That's what he does here. Upavishyasane yunjyat yogam atma vishuddhaye. Atma vishuddhaye means in order to get the purification mind, or in order to get the pure mind is the goal, one should be sticking with that. All these 8 things must be observed. Then the next words, prashantatma vigata bhihi brahmachari vratay sthitaha manas samyamyam chittaha yukta asita matparaha. Now he is coming to the main portion of meditation. Prashantatma vigata bhihi. Prashantatma means, we call it samadhanam. Samadhanam means the mind which exists without any layers in it. Just peaceful, silent mind. No fear. No single bit of the fear about birth or life or survival. Even people, you know, they have always pressure about survival. We call it yoga kshemam. So this yoga kshemam, yoga means earning money. Kshema means in order to protect. This yoga kshema must be taken care of. Therefore, I worry about every day. every day how it goes. And even spiritual people worry about our own karma pala. You know, we are traveling in the spiritual path. We have not done anything good. We don't know whatever that we have done. So we need to have proper punya. This papa and punya, they may come. We should not get deviated. This is what the expectations with bhakta. But the meditator should not worry about yoga and just to surrender to the Lord. He has to give himself to the Lord. Lord will take care of it. He has to sit without a fear. Brahmachari vrate sthitaha. This brahmacharya vrata means if making oneself with a quality mind one. I think you are not understanding what I say. Because when you go along with your indriyas, they will make you to engage with lots of fun in the world. All of them will suck your energy. Be focused in the subject matter. Your energy will be saved. Those energy will help you to have a proper understanding about yourself. Manas samyamya machittaha yukta asita matparaha. Having established his mind or your mind in me, you will get a proper meditation. Machittaha yuktaha asita matparaha asita. Just, you know, you focus on me, establish yourself in my thought, you just be there. That's what yunjita, yogi yunjita satatam. That's what we saw in the beginning. Atmanam ragasisthitaha. Atmanam, being in a secluded place, yogi should get connected with myself as his self. He just continues. Yunjan nevam sadatmanam yogi niyatam anasaha shantim nirvana paramam mat samstham adhigacchati. Now he gives the completeness of the meditation. Where he reaches, where the meditation, the process takes you to set yourself. Evam yunjanna, evam sada yogi niyatamanasaha atmanam yunjanna. Thus the yogi, having been established in myself as himself, in himself, he just gets a proper unlimited moksha alone. That he explains more. We will continue from the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.